I'm Madeline White. Idahoans gathering at the Idaho State Capitol again today for a protest calling for action following the death of George Floyd. As Idaho News 6's Steve Dent reports, a new organization has formed with the idea of peaceful protests to promote change in our society.
We're not here for a photo op. We're here for change.
Peaceful Roots for Change organized a protest on the steps of the Capitol.
Why do I have to be held to a higher standard than the man that holds a badge to protect the community?
It's a new organization that officially started last Monday.
Rather than being afraid, we decided to actually start our own organization and try to get some boots on the ground actually working to fight for change.
Peaceful Roots for Change put together last Sunday's protest, despite pushback from the black community.
We got shut down a lot of times by the black community leaders, like, oh, we shouldn't do this, we shouldn't do that. And I really felt like that's wrong. I feel like I should be able to come out here every day and speak out my mind as long as I'm doing it peacefully.
Dozens of people showed up in the rain to protest in the wake of George Floyd's brutal death.
The systemic racism exists. People are being locked up in cages and beaten for no repercussions whatsoever. And that needs to stop. It's not just about George Floyd. It's much bigger than that. And unless you can recognize that, we don't need you in the movement, whether you're police, whether you're a boogaloo boy, or some sort of other cringe lord that is unaffiliated. We don't need you.
It has certainly been an interesting first week for this new organization.
We've been getting hecklers here every day, like people harassing us with guns. Like, there's barely of us. I'm not holding a gun. I'm not holding anything.
Leaders of Peaceful Roots for Change tell us they experience racism here in Idaho.
It's going to come in the form of people locking their doors when you walk by their car. It's going to come in the form of people crossing the street when you're walking down the street. It's going to come in the form of people throwing away your job application because your name sounds too ethnic.
But the leaders of this movement hope to change how people of color get treated, and they have more rallies and educational events planned.
Trying to bridge the gap between the academic educational side and the people who are on the ground really, really willing to actually fight, and trying to bring those people together under one roof and for action.
Steve Dent, Idaho News 6.
While the protests continue in Idaho, it is also important to look at the past struggles for human rights to help understand the context. Boise's first major civil rights protest happened in 1968 when the governor didn't lower the flag after the assassination of Martin Luther King Jr. That protest on the steps of the Capitol led to the creation of the Idaho Human Rights Commission and a new law passed in 1969.
Why do we join a Black Lives Matter movement without understanding the history that has created that need, created the statement with it? And so that's so much what the memorial recognizes, and that's very much the purpose of why we have the history of human rights in Idaho there, that they are going to provide context.
The Wasmith Center for Human Rights manages the only Anne Frank Memorial in the country in Boise, and the executive director tells us the fight for human rights never ends.